Good morning, class. Today I will continue with the same chapter, Dusk, right? And I think I had explained till page 58. So in the story, we find that there's a young man who was in trouble and who had lost his hotel name. He had lost his money, isn't it? So now we find that this man or this young man was just making up stories. With that reflection, Gotsby rose to go. As he did so, an exclamation of concern escaped him. So when he was about to leave that place or that bench where he was sitting, he realized that he was very, very hard-hearted towards a young man. So he felt bad about the young man's problem. Lying on the ground beside the bench was a small oval packet, wrapped and sealed with the solicitude of chemist counter. So he found that there was a small packet lying on the ground, right, and it had the receipt of that chemist's shop also. It could be nothing else but a cake of soap. So he realized that it could be nothing but a cake of soap, which had evidently fallen out of the youth's overcoat pocket when he flung himself down on the seat. So he thought that maybe it had fallen off from that young man's pocket when he had come to sit on the bench. In another moment, Gotsby was in anxious quest for a youthful figure in a light overcoat. So he thought that that young man had dropped that bar of soap from that pocket. He had nearly given up the search when he caught sight of the object of his pursuit standing irresolutely on the border of the carriage drive. So when he was about to leave, he found that there was somebody waiting for him and she was just looking at him. He turned round sharply when he found Gotsby hailing him. So when this man was about to leave, all right, he realized that this Gotsby was just looking at him properly. "The important witness to the genuineness of your story has turned up," said Gotsby, holding out the cake of soap. So he picked up that cake of soap from the ground, all right, and he gave it to the young man. And he said that it was his. "I saw it on the ground after you left." So Gotsby had found that soap after the young man had left. "You must excuse my disbelief, but appearances were really rather against you." So at the beginning, Norman Gotsby did not like this young man at all. Alright? "And now as I appeal to the testimony of the soap, I think I ought to abide by its verdict. If the loan of a sovereign is any good to you." So he decided to give some amount of money to this young man, thinking that it would help him. The young man hastily removed all doubt on the subject by pocketing the coin. So he gave some money to this young man, all right? And so that young man, he hurriedly put those coins in the pocket, thinking that he would lose the coins again. "Here is my card with my address," continued Gotsby. So he took out his visiting card, all right? And he gave to the young man, saying that this is my address. "Any day this week will do for returning the money." So he had given that visiting card to the young man, thinking that young man would come and return the money to him on any day of the week. "And here is the soap." So he also gave that soap to this young man. "Don't lose it again. It's been a good friend to you." So Gotsby, he asked this young man not to lose that soap again because it had been a friend of his. "Lucky thing you're finding it," said the youth. So the young man was very happy because he got the money as well as he got the soap. And then with a catch in his voice, he blurted out a word or two of thanks. So he was very, very happy. So he went on thanking Norman Gotsby and fled headlong in the direction of Knightsbridge. So as soon as he got the money and the soap from this man, Norman Gotsby, he thanked him and he just went away from there immediately. Poor boy, he has as nearly as possible broke down. So Gotsby felt very sad for this young man, thinking that this boy was really in trouble. said Godspeed to himself. So he was talking to himself and he realized that he had made a mistake of assuming that this boy was a bad human being. It's a lesson to me not to be too clever in judging by circumstances. So Godspeed, he learned a lesson never to judge anyone very, very fast. Sometimes what happens, we assume, isn't it, things very, very fast, which is not good. So even Godspeed, he realized his mistake by judging the young man very, very fast. As Godspeed retraced his steps past the seat where the little drama had taken place, he saw an elderly gentleman poking and peering beneath it. So as he was about to leave from the place where he was sitting and all the drama had taken place, he saw that there was an old man who was trying to look for something, right? He was trying to look here and there. He was trying to look under the bench. And on all sides of it, and recognized his earlier fellow occupant. So when he saw this old gentleman, Norman Godspeed realized, or he remembered, that he was the same gentleman who was sitting with him on the bench, right, when all this incident took place. So this gentleman had left, isn't it? He had already left the place, and as soon as he left, the young man had come. So now again, Godspeed was very surprised to see that this old gentleman was there and she was looking for something. "Have you lost anything, sir?" he asked. So Godspeed asked this old gentleman whether he had lost anything because he was looking for something or he was searching something. "Yes, sir, a cake of soap." So this old gentleman said that he was looking for a cake of soap which he had dropped, right, while he had come to sit on that bench in the evening. So children, it was not the youth, the young man's soap, isn't it? It was that old man's bar of soap which he had bought and he had dropped while he had come to sit on that bench. But luckily or unluckily, Godspeed had found it and he thought that that cake also belonged to the young man, so he gave it to him. So the young man had become very, very happy because he got money as well as he had got a bar of soap which he needed. So I have finished with the chapter, all right, and I will send you the PDF again if I have not sent. If I have sent you, please do the meanings in your English literature copy. Thank you.